boy Dalmoon. Okay. Check this out. I did a video a while back about the arm that is supposed to magically do everything. Well, it did do everything. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you another idea I have that maybe this will work. So take it.
Please welcome
DJ
Moose.
Hit it.
Okay, so what I went and done was I got a few items in the Home Depot. I got a dowel rod. An inch and a quarter is oak. Got an oak dowel rod. I got all thread 24 inches long. Quarter inch. Then I got this turnbuckle, which is quarter inch turnbuckle. And it came with a quarter inch hook. And it came with an eye bolt. Approximately 2.5 inches long. This will work. What we're gonna do is the idea is this is gonna be the handle and this is gonna go through it. It's gonna be bolted to the handle. I'm gonna paint it. So the bolts get locked. The bolts are going to be locked by the process I'm going to show you how to do it. And the bolts are going to be locked, but I'm also going to paint them black. That way, the handle's going to be painted black too, so it's all going to be painted and it'll be done, taken care of, and then we'll take this eye bolt and put it in the 2x4 of the cart. And then we will go ahead and go from there. And what this is going to do, this will be in the cart, and this will be there, and I can just hook it in and pull it. And then we can pull it through the dirt, grass, and everything else. And all this will be locked in place. So I'm going to show you the process. I'm going to show you how I do it. Everything's going to be on speed of Rooney. So, you get the whole project, and you get an idea of how to do a project like this. And I will stop from time to time and share with you my thoughts on different things. So, let's get into this. You'll need a saw, particularly, it doesn't matter what kind of saw. I got a saw rod. They cut everything, but I got this blade. It's a bimetal blade. And then this, my drill, my chuck. And we are going to go with some of my tools here that I have. And the marking pen. And then I found a hook here. Get right here that I'm going to use, go in there, and this should be about the right size. And it'll be right. And so, what we're going to do is we're going to show you how to do this safely, efficiently, and get the job done so you could basically maybe do the same project. Or if you have other ideas, let me know in the comments below. But the blue cart, the way the blue cart is, the blue cart has a strap already on it. And it's already got an eye bolt on it. So all I have to do with that is hook this in that strap and then pull it. So that's pretty much that. So I really don't need to do much with it. It's just getting this together. And I'm basically going to show you a little trick that I learned in sheet metal school. And it's something that a lot of sheet metal workers learn. And that is how to cut stuff safely. And when you're in the field, you don't have vices. When you're in the field, you're on the ground, or you're trying to find some place that you can stick it at and cut it. So I've got this little table here. We're going to cut it off the table. And let me go get the The typical off-rip that you use in construction is 3/8. When you hang ductwork off a rafter, you're supposed to use 3/8. 3/8 to half inch to 5/8 off-rip, depending on what you're hanging. But what you'll do is they got a thing that you get. Basically what you're going to do is you're going to take two of these like this. A lot of times they don't call for turnbuckles. They call for just doubles. And what I mean by doubles, that every time that you hang ductwork, you double the nut. No matter what it is, always double the nut. When you're hanging from the trapeze, you get the angle, and you put the angle on. Then you take and you put one on each side. It depends. Every 6 feet is how a trapeze would hang. So if you ever go to a place, look at the ductwork. It's every 6 feet is considered a trapeze. It depends on what they use. Some of them are round duct, so they use a round strap. Don't kid you, that's just sheet metal that's fabricated at the sheet metal shop to look cool. And then they, especially like at HEB and stuff, and they paint them the color they want, Walmart, the same thing. Unless they don't want the color, they just want the paint. So this is basically it. This right here is going to be painted black now. The bolts here, when you're usually doing construction, especially like fabricating and stuff for to do commercials. What'll happen is you put the ductwork in, and if you read the blueprint, it'll say exactly how they want. They want it wrapped with fiberglass, or not insulation. And so, being union, I didn't have to worry about that. But when I became a journeyman, guess what? I wasn't union, so I had to do it myself. I had to do the whole process. And that's a duck stuff. But anyway, so this right here should be the trick. I'm going to paint it black. It's going to all be black. All these bolts are going to be painted black. Everything's going to be painted black. And I'm going to let it cure, and then we are going to do the test. But what we're going to do now, tomorrow, is I'm going to put this in the 2x4, and basically how I'm going to do is the 2x4 is just going to go down there, and this is going to go, it's going to go like this, I'll set it up for you so you can get an idea of what it's going to look like. I don't think he's going to go in there. I think I have a little different size. For some reason, I used to be a different size than a quarter inch. I'll have to get a quarter inch. I have to get one of these. I think I got something to fit these, but if not, I'll take this to Home Depot and get the bolt and just fit it the way it is. So, this right here is the new look for the speaker stand. For the sub, bringing the sub and the card in. The hook will go on the piece, and I can just bring it on in. And then I can take it off, and then I can put it on the sub. Now, this ain't gonna hang around, so it doesn't look like that other one. The other one looks so stupid. I don't even know why I did this in the first place. But I was trying to not have to invent stuff like this. But this is an invention of a lifetime. As you can see, this one doesn't have double. I will have a double nut on it. I will put another double nut, and it'll be ready to go. Actually, I think this is worth this one. I don't know. And then tomorrow I'll show you round two. And we will go ahead and say, subscribe to my channel. Ring my bell for notifications. Like this video and others. Go ahead and hit the like button if you like what you're here. Don't like it to her, go ahead and hit the don't like button. And the rumor is true. They do got the cactus jack over there at McDonald's. I saw it on the billboard. So the rumor is true. They got his own burger. Tried to stop burger. Okay. So the book for today is, every workout is progress. Peace.